Hello children, welcome to science class for 4th standard. So the topic is adaptations in animals of lesson 3. So already we have learned about adaptations for habitat, adaptations for food. So let us today learn about adaptations for protection. So every animal needs to be protected from its enemies and surroundings also. So these animals develop various ways to protect themselves. So let us today learn about how these different animals protect itself from the enemies and the surroundings. Let me start with the deer and camels. So how these animals can protect itself from its enemies? So these animals like deer and kangaroo are escape from its enemies because of its speed and swiftness. So whenever an animal comes to attack, it can run very fast in the forest. So it is very, it can easily escape from its enemies like that. Okay children? And next is rabbits, hares and rats. Rabbits, hares and rats makes burrows deep into the soil to escape from its enemies like owls, eagles and cats. So it can escape easily. Whenever this animal attacks it, so what these animals will do? It will make a burrow in the soil and it will run inside the burrow. So it can escape like that. Okay children, next is whales, elephants and hippos. How these animals are? So when I say this name only, you can come to know that it is very huge. These animals are big in size. Because of its size only it can escape. So these whales, elephants and hippos can easily escape from their enemies because of its big size. And also they are too big to be eaten by other animals. Whenever the animal wants to attack it, by seeing this, by seeing the elephant or hippos or whales, by seeing the size only, it runs away. Okay, so like this, because of its size only, it can protect itself from the enemies. Like, and next is polar bear. So how polar bears are? Polar bears are in white color. So these animals can easily merge with the surroundings. So it can. It is very difficult to locate polar bear in the snow because of it, because of white snow, because the snow is in white color. So the polar bear can easily hide there, and as it can easily hunt other animals also. So what animals are available there, so easily it can attack, and as it can merge with the surroundings and like that protects itself. Okay children, so next is chameleon or gyrgit. Chameleon or gyrgit can change its color to the surroundings, to match the surroundings. So it can change the color to match the surroundings. So what these animals will do, whenever it sits on any leaf or a brick or a tree or a branch of a tree, so it changes its color. So it merges with so well with the surroundings, so it can easily protect itself from the enemies. So that is called camouflage. So that is called camouflage. Okay children, so next is tigers and zebras. Tigers and zebras, I will show the picture here so you can see the stripes on their body. So these stripes help them to escape from their enemies, so which help them to merge with the surroundings. So it can in the long grass and plants, it can in the forest, it can easily hide there, can protect themselves. And also these animals can easily hunt other animals because of the stripes on their body. So it can easily, which help them to merge with their surroundings in long grass and plants of the forest. Okay, next is the leaf insect and stick insect. You can see in the picture here the leaf insect and the stick insect. The leaf insect looks like a leaf while the stick insect looks like the twig of a plant. So their color and shapes merge so well with the surroundings that it is very difficult for the enemy to detect its presence. So it can easily, it can merge with the surroundings. So it is very difficult for the enemy to detect its presence. You can see in the picture here, you cannot make out it is a stick. It looks like a twig here, isn't it? And then leaf insect is exactly like a leaf only. So like that, it can protect itself from its enemies. Okay children, so next is porcupine. So porcupine has sharp pointed quills on their body to protect itself from the enemies. So no need of doing anything. So it has got sharp quills on its body. So no any other animal will dare to attack the porcupine there. So like that it will easily protect itself. Okay, next is tortoise and snakes. Tortoise and snakes have shells on their body. You have seen, isn't it? You can see in the picture also here. So tortoise and snakes have shells on their bodies. Whenever they face any danger, they go into the shells and they hide inside there. So like that, it will protect itself. And the next is a cuttlefish. A cuttlefish has a sac on their body. So what it will do, whenever it faces a danger, it releases the ink. Okay, it releases ink in the water. So that makes the water blue in color. So this, what this fish will do, it will swim to the safer place. So when the water becomes blue in color, what happens? The enemy cannot see properly there. So what this fish will do? It will swim to a safer place. So the enemy is not able to see it. Okay, like that it will do. The cuttlefish has ink sacs. It has got ink sacs on its body. Whenever any animal attacks it, so what it will do? It releases the ink into the water. So the water becomes blue in color. And the easily it can escape and it will run away from the will swim to further in a safer place. Okay, next is migration. So what is migration, children? Regular movement of birds and animals. Regular movement of some birds and animals in large number to escape from its unfavorable conditions. As to escape from unfavorable conditions in a particular time of a year is known as migration. Is known as a migration. Okay, so these animals and birds will migrate from one place to another. So for example, Siberian crane. So an example they have given, and also they have shown the picture here. So it comes to India every year in winters. Okay, it comes to India every year in winters. So it travels so very long distance. It travels and comes every year in winters. Comes to India itself, particularly this bird they have given in the picture, no? This one. Okay, children. So, one amazing facts they have given here. So, few more animals they have given, and birds also, and fish also. So, let us read and come to know pufffish. See in the picture here? Pufffish. So, pufffish can escape from shark fish by puffing like a balloon. It can escape from shark by puffing like a balloon. You can see in the picture here. It will puff itself like this, like a balloon. So the this makes the sharp spines on its body to stand out. So this makes the, there will be sharp spines on its body. So when it puffs, so what happens? That spines will stand like a stand out. So that the shark cannot eat or swallow the puff fish. The shark cannot eat or swallow the pufffish, like that it protects itself. And then next is the Arctic tern is the greatest migratory bird. The Arctic tern is the greatest migratory bird. Every year it flies 30,000 km from Arctic to Antarctic region and back. So it flies 30,000 km, children. So like that it migrates. It is the greatest migratory bird. So that is Arctic tern. So next is European eels. European eels swim all the way to Sargasso Sea. So it swims all the way to Sargasso Sea of Atlantic Ocean to lay eggs. So it swims all the way to Sargasso Sea. And then what happens? The baby eels then take 3 years to swim back to the European rivers. So the European eels will come very long distance. It will travel and it will lay eggs and it will go back. So then what happens? The young ones, what they will do, the baby eels will swim back to the same place, swim back to the European rivers. It will take 3 years to swim back to them. So, these are the amazing facts what I have read here. And as a children, I would like to show the pictures here. So, the chameleon means this one. It changes its color to the match to its surroundings. This is called Girgit or chameleon. And you can see the polar bear also here. So, you cannot locate it when it is in the snow. Okay, children. So let me conclude my class here. I hope you have understood. In the next class, I'll give you the notes for this lesson. Okay, children. next class. Thank you.